Hello there, fellow YouTubers. It's Underdrummer here. I am going to talk today about Skate 3 and how it is fucking killing me. Actually, let me start my intro over. I've noticed a trend, kind of a disturbing one, actually, in YouTube videos lately. And maybe it's been going on longer than I know of, but I just noticed it recently. You not only want to say your intro as quickly as you can, hello there, fellow YouTubers, it's Underdrummer here, but you also want to slur your name like you're on your 11th beer out of a 12-pack. So let me try. Let me try again. Hi there, fellow YouTubers. Yeah, I just thought I'd like to talk about Skate 3 today. I could probably do better. I'll probably get better at that as time goes on. My skills in that area will improve, and I'll watch some PewDiePie to get the hang of that there. Sunderdummer. Hi, guys. Sunderdummer here. Hi, how you doing? Sunderdummer here. I just thought I'd, with Skate 4 being a very real possibility, I thought I'd take this time to talk about all the shitty things that it did wrong, and there's a lot, so let's get started. I got everything written down right here, and I'm reading it, and like, I think I wrote 2 pages of stuff that bothered me about this game. So, Skate 3, let me say right off the bat, is one of the most frustrating... I'm deep-throating the controller. One of the most frustrating games I have played in a long, long, long time, like since I was a kid. It does a lot of stuff right, but it gets even more stuff wrong. The wrong things are just little wrong things, but they're present long enough, they're around long enough just to bother the shit out of you. The flick stick to do tricks and jumps is mind-bogglingly difficult. I mean, sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't work. In my experience, tiny nuances in timing can change each trick. For example, I might do a kickflip by pressing down and then slightly to the northeast. Well, if you go down and then move your thumb while your controller is down to the right at all and then to the northeast, you do a completely different trick. I mean, it's mind-bogglingly difficult. Bog can't even say it. Bogglingly. Mind-bog-gog-gog. Depending on the way you're riding your board, it changes the set of controls. I mean, that to me, that is not a good game mechanic. If your left foot is on the front of your board, the trick will be different than if your right foot is on the front of the board. Maybe this is normal in the skating world, but definitely counterintuitive to any video gamer. At certain points, I thought I was losing my fucking mind. I wasn't telling my skater to stand differently. Somehow he was doing it on his own. I don't know. Maybe you finish a trick and your guy comes out of the trick and into a different position. But anyways, he kept changing. So that means the trick controls kept changing. At one point, I just almost fucking lost it. I do my trick, right trigger X. Wasn't working. I'd have to stop, go to the menu, look. Oh, it's left trigger X now. Okay, left trigger X. I do that for a little while. Then he wouldn't do it. I'd go check the trick book. And no, it's right trigger X. And it's like the game was fucking with me. Let's talk about the music track. The game's got a good soundtrack. But the way that it implements the music system is horrendous. You can't change music when you're in a challenge. So the songs that you've picked are the songs you're going to listen to. You can't skip tracks. You can only restart tracks. So, you know, if that doesn't describe perfect music hell, oh, you hate this song? Well, all you can do is restart it. I mean, why? When the track plays, it doesn't show who the song is performed by. Well, that's nice. You know, if I was an artist lucky enough to get on Skate 3, can you please show who the fucking song is by? Show my band name for 2 seconds? No, you have to go to a completely different alternate menu to choose which tracks you want to play. You check them or uncheck them, and then inside that menu, they're kind enough to show you who the song is by. Checkpoints. What is up with the controls for setting checkpoints? I don't think I've ever seen this button combination in any other game. Left bumper up on the control pad? I mean, I obviously played it on the 360. You played on the PS, PlayStation 3 as well, but, you know, it's just a horrible button combination. To set your checkpoint is left bumper down. To go back to your checkpoint is left bumper up. And you're just, you know, the little tiny controls in the control pad, it's fucking annoying. I mean, that needs to change in Skate 4 for sure. Oh, if you use a checkpoint, your completed challenges go away. So say I'm in a challenge section. I've got 4 challenges, and I've completed 2. I got 2 more to go. By the way, if you die during any of these challenge sections, you lose. You got to start over. got 14 challenges. You got to do them all again. The checkpoint system is nice to have, even though it's implemented in a fucked up way. But if I use it, I get penalized. I lose my challenge, already completed challenges in that section. So what's the point of it if they're going to penalize me for using it? I mean, might as well not even have thrown it in the game. This is a good one. Tricks are listed by different names. Yeah. Yeah, you may be like me, who's never skated in their entire life. You're supposed to infer which trick the game wants you to do. And there's a couple hundred different tricks. So going back and forth to the menu every 5 minutes, looking up how to do the trick in your current skater's orientation is fucking annoying. It's a horrible way to memorize things. You actually have to memorize two sets of controls per trick. So if there's a couple hundred tricks, that's like 400 different things you got to remember. Oh, I'm fucking, my left foot's in the front, so it's right bumper X. Oh, wait, my right foot's in the front, so it's left bumper X. Fuck. That might be how it is in real life, but this ain't fucking real life. This is a video game. Oh, the people. People walk around everywhere. If you touch a person, you die. If you can punch people and knock them down to get them out of your way, but if you do that too much, they'll tase you. People always seem to show up at crucial moments in a challenge when you're about to perform your final trick on the challenge list to finish that section. I swear the game knows. It starts propagating people right there in front of you, in front of your line where you're trying to do your trick. It knows. It's happened too many times for it to be coincidental. I mean, sometimes it feels like a fighting game. There's you're really surrounded by these mindless zombies that just happen to be walking on this, in this park or on this pier, or you could be in crazy places. You could be in, on a boat, and there's six people walking around. What the fuck are you doing here? I'm trying to do tricks, and you're fucking walking around here, getting in front of, And then once you do knock them out, you can punch them or hit them with your skateboard. They tase you, which also screws you up and knocks you off your line. I mean, sometimes it does. It feels like a beat 'em up game. It feels like a fighting game. I don't understand the reason for the people. And it would be okay if there was an option to turn that shit off, but there's not. People are there. You got to deal with them. If you hang out in one area too long, yes, that's when the game starts. I mean, sometimes to a ridiculous point to where there's, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 15 people walking in the little area that you're trying to do a grind on. They're intentionally in your way to add another layer of difficulty to the game. The stuff they say, I turned off the dialogue long ago. The cutscenes will drive you bonkers, unless you're into that skate lingo. Hey, bro, what's up? Hey, I mean, if I was a skater, I'd be pissed. Every cutscene sounds like the guy just does nothing but skate and smoke weed all day long. I mean, if that describes skaters all over the world, then okay. But to me, it's kind of biased. Is there any skater out there that, hey, bro, doesn't talk like this? Hey, cool line, man. just shut the dialogue stuff off. It's, change that shit in Skate 4. Why don't you make some skaters talk like regular fucking people? When you do the pro section, the pros, there you play a level or challenge, I should say, where the pro is doing his trick thing, and it's the same thing you're supposed to do. You're kind of supposed to go behind him and do the same thing, but you have your list over here to the right of stuff you're supposed to do. Well, a lot of times the pros get in your way, just like the regular people, the non-player characters, I guess we'll call them, they get in your way. Well, the pros keep, you can wait for the pro to run his trick, do his line. The problem is, after he runs it, the game resets him and he starts doing it over again. So the pros constantly running the same line that you're trying to run. A line is, let me define some terms. I mean, I think I've become a skate fucking aficionado from playing this game. This game will teach you, will force you to learn the terminology. A line is just, a set of tricks in between starting and crashing. So you start, you do 10,000 point line from point A to point B, and then you wreck. That's your line. Well, the pro is doing the same line that you're supposed to do. So he's always in your way. I mean, the chances of hitting them is increased because they're running the same line as you. You can't just wait for them to finish and then do yours. They're constantly doing it for eternity in skater hell. They're constantly doing the same. It's like you're in some kind of fucked up dimension where, I don't, Josh Kallick or some other skater is doing the same six tricks in the same section from A, B to C all for fucking eternity. And until you got to, I mean, you can even hit them and knock them out of the way, but they fucking reload and they start over again. Not being able to leave an area, a challenge area. You got 3 out of 4 tricks done in a challenge area, and you know, want to build up some speed, so you cruise on down the patio a little further. Game will flash at you. Don't leave this. You're leaving the area, and it doesn't start you over. It doesn't start your challenges over, thank God, but it does warn you, and then the screen goes staticky, and it warps you back to where you're supposed to be. I just got to say, why? What am I going to do? Go get another skater who's better than me, dress him up in my clothes, have him come back and finish the challenge for me? I mean, that's not even possible. Why can't I leave? You know, this little shit like this, it just nags at you through the whole game. This little tiny thing. Oh, well, that's really annoying. I can't leave the area. Well, maybe if I could change the fucking song, it wouldn't be so bad. But all I can do is restart the same song over. I can't stand the song, but I can listen to it from the beginning every time. The timer. Why am I timed for tricks? Not only do I have to do the tricks, which in itself is extremely difficult, but I have to do them within a certain time limit? I mean, oh, it's like the designers were trying to show you how hard skating is in real life. You know, it's like they're like, you know, there's just so many obstacles in your way and people and the little nuances of the trick. It's like, I know that skating is probably pretty difficult in real life, but I ain't skating in real life. I'm skating in a fucking video game. Should be enjoyable, not impossible. Don't time me. There's no need for the timer. I mean, the game is difficult enough. Seriously, sometimes the game felt like a job, like a lifestyle decision instead of a video game. The trick analyzer. You can turn on a trick analyzer, which will show you what direction you're pressing your thumbstick, you know, up, down. It's completely fucking broken. I mean, for one, you can't turn it on or off during a challenge. If it's on, you start a challenge, it fucking stays on. So if it's annoying you, gotta quit your challenge. If you for some reason you're like, oh, maybe the trick analyzer will help me, which you would be completely wrong in assuming. You can't turn it on during a challenge. You gotta stop the challenge, quit the challenge. The thing is delayed. It's not accurate. You know, you'll definitely do a half moon down here, and it'll show a fucking diagonal line going across like that. Half the time, it don't show shit. It won't even, you'll do something, it won't even register. It's like it was an afterthought, like they threw it in the last second. So why the fuck is it there? That's what I got to say. It's completely useless, and it's completely useless. Why is it there? A little other annoying thing, in the Hall of Meat, for those of you who don't know what that is, it's actually probably the best part of the game. You dive off of buildings and you bail off your board and try to smack into the ground and destroy as many body parts as you can, bust as many bones as you can. It's really fun. It's the only unrealistic portion of the game. And it really helps the game being there. If it wasn't for Hall of Meat, I probably never would have continued playing this game. Because it's the actual arcade, the video game portion of the game that I enjoy. Not the realistic, and some people go for the realistic stuff. I get that. But what's the game trying to do? Is it trying to be realistic and not be realistic? It's like what so many other video games suffer from today is, let's have something for everybody. No! Do what you do, and if the people don't fucking like it, they'll go buy a different game. Each game that comes out is just going to become kind of the same thing, of an all-inclusive. We do realistic stuff. We do arcade-style stuff. We do shooters, and we do beat-em-ups. We don't want that. Video gamers don't want that. We want specific styles, certain to specific genres that do specific things. That's why I'll play this game. I'll play A, and I won't play B. I'll play B, and I won't play C. So anyways, during the Hall of Meat when you die, or even outside of the Hall of Meat when you wreck, it goes into a nice little slow motion, which is cool for like the first 5 minutes, and then afterwards you just wish it would leave because you're jamming on buttons ready to start the line over again. Well, when it goes into slow motion, if you hit start to go into the menu is in slow motion. So now you're not even seeing anything cool slow motion on the screen, because let's admit slow motion is pretty cool. But you're watching words within the menu going slow. So you're moving your controller down, and the option, the arrow is going brr, brr. It's just one of the little things that nags about this game. Speaking of, you know, like slow motion and timers, and I don't know about you, but when I'm trying to do something on a video game and I fail, I want to get back to trying as quickly as I can. One, maximum two, three button press total. You know, oh, I fucked up. Start right on the thumbstick. A. Let me try again. Not with Skate 3. Every time you start over, you use your checkpoint and start the challenge section over. Yep, there's a 3-second counter. 3, 2, 1. It's horrifying. Why? Let me shut it off. I don't need a timer. This is the 15th million time I've tried to do this set of tricks. I don't need a fucking timer. It's not like I'm getting ready to run a race. Okay, put it at the race so I can get ready. And if you're going to include that, have a little button that I can press. It'll give me a boost when I start the race. There's no need for the timer except to piss off the player. That's really what I think Skate 3 does best, is piss off the player. Oh, man. Obscure and cryptic challenge description. What the fuck is a Manny to Gap Manny the big wall? Okay, let's dissect that. What is the big wall? There's blue arrows over what you're supposed to trick on, and they're not exactly over what you're supposed to trick on. So you're in a parking lot. There's walls all over the fucking place. Which one is the big fucking wall? That wall's big. That wall's fucking bigger. The wall over there is even fucking bigger. Wait, why don't you have a specific arrow that's like, you know, red arrow, big wall. Oh, there's a red fucking arrow. I'm supposed to trick over that big wall. Purple arrow, do this over here on this rail. Oh, this rail. Okay. I mean, wouldn't that make more sense? And then learning the terminology in this game, the game actually has a terminology section that explains only a few terms so that you can understand what you're supposed to do. What other video game is it not clear what the fuck your character's supposed to be doing? I mean, isn't that the point of a video game? It's like Pac-Man, but you don't know if you're supposed to eat the fucking ghosts or eat the dots. Well, the game doesn't fucking tell you, and it's not intuitive. You don't just know. So you start tricking on all kinds of things. Nothing's popping up, so you're not doing it right. I mean, if it wasn't for YouTube, this game would be broken. Skate 3 would be broken. Unless you had a group of people that played it for a million years, you know, without the internet, and they could tell you what to do. Manny is a manual. And the manual is just pressing down on the right thumbstick so that your guy kicks back the board. I don't want to learn the stupid fucking skating terms. I didn't buy it to become a skater. I bought it to play a fucking video game in which you skate in. Many times throughout the game, if you play this, you're going to go, what does the game want me to do? I'll fucking try to do it. I'll try my damnedest to do it, but just please tell me what you want me to do. Manny to Gap to Manny to Rail to Bit. Oh, jeez. Oh. So you go into the terminology section and you find out what it is. It doesn't always tell you how to do it. It just tells you what it is. And some of the descriptions are fucking retarded. The way it described a rail is, rails come in many shapes and sizes, but they're always skinny things to grind on. Okay, I guess I know what a fucking rail is now. In a challenge section where you're trying to do multiple challenges, 9, 10, you only get to see 5 challenges. I guess they figured they couldn't fit it on the fucking screen. You can't see the rest of the challenges until you do the challenges that are there, which means it's kind of making the decision for you which challenges you're going to do in what order. So on top of being timed, trying to figure out how you're supposed to do the tricks, what specific tricks you're supposed to do where, it also gets to tell you which order of tricks you do. I mean, the game's my boss, and this is my fucking job, and I'm in hell. Pretty much. There's beating the challenges, which is called owning it. Nothing in this game is what it should be called. It's a complete set of new language. Learn the fucking skating language. Beating it the first time, or beating it doing the first set of challenges, is called owning it. Beating the challenge section the second time, and the more difficult, is called killing it. So, well, who knows? Killing it was better than owning it. I mean, if you're a fucking Surfer or you're fucking 12, then maybe you know that, dude, you killed it. It's better than, dude, you just owned it. I didn't fucking know that until I played this game. So you basically can't do the killing section because the game won't show you what you're supposed to, what things you're supposed to do. Your challenges change when you go to kill it versus when you're owning it. I can't believe I'm even talking this way. But you really don't get to see how to kill it until you own it, which means you have to do each set of challenges twice. And there's a shitload of challenges, like 80, more than 80. When you're in the trick book section, it doesn't allow you to practice. You know, it would be nice if it just kind of said hit A to practice and it showed you your trick and it showed your guy doing your trick and you're like, okay, down, northeast, then southwest, and then A, and then right bumper. Okay, I see how to do a fucking Quizly Quackle Manalboo to the flip side G fucking Stalefish. Fuck you. You know, this game is more like pushing the skating culture on the player than it is really trying to entertain. Kind of feels like a very long fucking commercial. Do we play Call of Duty to learn about Marine Corps responsibilities and terminologies and you know, all the aspects of the soldier world? Well, maybe a tiny bit, but not as much as Skate 3 wants to teach you about real-life skating. It's like the game was made by skaters. There is more emphasis on the culture of skating than there is on gameplay. It's a fucking video game. If you have to YouTube 9 out of every 10 challenges to find out what the fuck the game wants you to do, there's something wrong. Definitely needs to be addressed in Skate 4. You should be able to play the game without the fucking internet. If you can't play the game without looking up what to do on the internet, I mean, okay, certain games I understand. You're stuck. You've been stuck for hours. You've got to go on. You got to fucking call somebody. You know, back in the old days, you would call a hotline number or get Nintendo Power. Nowadays, you get online, you get on the YouTube. Okay, the YouTube. You get on YouTube and you find out what the fuck am I supposed to do. But when you have to do it for every single fucking challenge, something is wrong. 9 out of 10 challenges, I'm over here on the fucking computer. What the fuck is a Manny Gap to flip Stalefish fuck? In one section, one part of a three-part challenge, I had to do a fakey kickflip to rail. That's how they, you know, translated in fucking English. This means I need to get into what's known as fakey position, which translated further just means that I'm backwards in my stance. And the game never really describes to you what fakie is. It'll just throw shit at you that it's like, you're a skater now. You should fucking know, man. It doesn't really, there's no tutorial on the fakie part, and it doesn't ever tell you, even when you're in fakie mode, when you watch the YouTube video and you find out what the fuck is the mysterious fakie, you find out how to do it, the game doesn't show you. There's no heads-up display that says, you are now in fucking fakie mode. That would be nice. If it wasn't, once again, if it wasn't for YouTube, you couldn't fucking play this game. You couldn't beat it anyways. So the game doesn't tell you that. So three-part challenge. I need to do a fakie kickflip to rail. You need to do a kickflip, which is done differently, like I said before, depending on which way your skater's facing. So if you're fucking, your left foot's on the front, that means kickflip is down into the northwest. If your right foot is front, it's down south and to the northeast. So once you get all that down, then you need to grind fakey kickflip to grind rail. So I told you the game defines the rail as skinny things to grind. And if you don't know what the word grind means, then go fuck yourself. You shouldn't be playing Skate 3 anyways. I mean, that's what I feel like they're saying to me. So you know, basically you shouldn't be playing this game if you don't know what fucking grinding is. Yeah. So once again, it's just like, you know, be part of the skating culture of fuck you. So, and finally have to land the rail. So, where there are rails here for the steps, there's steps and there's rails and there's arrows. They're not rails, they're like handrails for you to, you know, guide you down the stairs. But you think you have to do a specific rail, or can I do any rail where there's a blue arrow? I mean, the blue arrow's gigantic, but it's kind of just like, this section! Like, if you're like, I need you to, you know, dig here. Where? Oh, in the backyard somewhere. Dig a hole. Well, specifically where? Somewhere there. The game purposely puts things in your way. Instead of giving the player an experience of, you know, more of speed and thrill and freedom, it's more of like, you fucking don't drive between these two things. I mean, just hitting a curb your guy goes flying. He's fucking done. You know, which is probably, again, how much it is in real life, but this is not real life. One challenge section required a trick while I get onto the island. There's water all around, you know, hence the term island, onto a cement platform, and then off again. And then so two places to die. When you're getting onto the cement island, you're supposed to bust a trick, and when you get off, you're supposed to bust a trick. So doing tricks is dangerous enough, but doing it over water. So there was four challenges to do, and two of them were over water. And then, if that's not bad enough, every time you came off your line, as soon as you went to your right, there was a curb there. Little things like that. There's just always something in your fucking way, which they're trying to say, hey, this is how real life is. This is how skating is. Not all places are, you know, skate parks designed for your safety in mind and for your ease of skating. So life's going to be hard. I didn't want a fucking job skating. I wanted to play a video game. The replay editor. Learning how to use the replay editor is like going to med school. I mean, there's so many working parts. It took me a day to get the hang of it. There's actually two pages of directions with little tiny writing. And stay away from the editor. Once you figure out how to use it, it's okay. It only allows one effect per edited clip. But again, it seems like an afterthought and just something to just make your life just a little bit more difficult. Trying to learn how to use the menus, post your video online is difficult. Watching your friends' replays, you got to fucking go to four different sections. Start, skate.real, the fuck is that? It brings you to a new menu. Then inside the menu, there's four different options. You have to community left. Then once you go up to community videos, then you have to right bumper over five sections and wait on the sections top rated as it loads the top rated clips, which you don't want, but you still have to wait for it to load. Then you finally can get to, you know, my friends. And then under, if your friends are listed there, if they have skate videos, you can watch them there. Half the challenges include the most difficult moves. The designers knew which moves were the most difficult, and they put them in almost every single fucking challenge. Not every single one, about half. Like, there's one called the hard flip. That's the name of the flip. And it really is named appropriately. It's fucking hard to do. Even the game admits pulling this off is, you know, kind of freaking amazing if you do it. What other game? The controls are like Call of Duty. Hey, you can use this weapon, but good luck getting it to work 9 times out of 10. It's a fucking miracle when it actually works. And then taking that gun, to use the same analogy, and putting it in half the levels, and you have to use that weapon. Oh, why? Fucking why? That's my question. Why? Even while you were trying to do a challenge, your offline skater buddies show up and constantly get in your way. And there's no option to turn this off. It's almost like instead of your buddy showing up when you're really, really trying to get down a trick line and they show up, it's like, hey, we're here to fuck you up, buddy. We're going to run into you constantly and get in your fucking way. Hey, pal. It's fucking horrendous. Get out of my way. And you can't turn it off. Your buddies come, you're in a section, you're in a certain area for too long. Your buddies come fucking popping in like, hey, we're here to fuck you up. Walking around off your skateboard is almost as dangerous as being on your skateboard. I don't know what is wrong with the controls for your guy just walking. Like, he trips and stumbles over everything. If you're doing a challenge, you aren't any safer off your board than you are on it. Just, you know, you're walking and your foot touches a curb, you die. You know, if you're walking and the level changes from here to here, if you don't jump or if you jump at the wrong time, your guy dies. And he's not even on a skateboard. He's a fucking, he must be stoned. He must be completely stoned out of his mind. I mean, that's what the game designers would have you think, that the way they talk, all these guys sound like fucking stoners. So he's completely stoned. He goes, oh, fuck, I tripped. Oh, fuck. Changing the difficulty doesn't actually change the challenges that you have to do. It only changes the physics in the game. So easy, less realistic physics. Hard, extremely real physics. I don't understand how that can be that helps. I mean, the game's pretty much just as hard on easy. At least it doesn't penalize you for playing on easy. There's no beating the game on hard. Because when you got a game that doesn't actually change anything except the physics, the actual way your guy reacts in that world, gravity is, you know, more like real gravity. When a game does that, there's no way they can hold you to play it on this difficulty. I don't know why you would. I mean, even if you want to be realistic, why would you play it on the hardest difficulty setting? It's not fun. You can't bust many tricks the correct way. You hardly get any air. I don't know. It's just another thing that nags me about this game. You know, a hard flip, like I was talking about before, it still just fucking is impossible to do. It doesn't change the, you know, wiggly woggly fucking little analog directional thing. It's just there's less gravity, so my guy might fly higher in the air, but I still have to fucking do the trick correctly. It doesn't, like, change the precision to where if I kind of get close to a half moon, it's like, ah, you did it. No, it doesn't change that. Sometimes you just follow a skater around, you know, a famous skater. He's going to go from point A to point B. You're going to follow him around and then listen to him talk. To me, that's one of the most boring sections of the game. It could be completely removed. Again, the developers are more interested in real-life skaters and skating culture versus making a fun video game. You know, and maybe I got it all wrong. And that's who Skate 3 is actually designed for, is real-life skaters. But if that's the case, then I can't see why real skaters would rather sit at home on a couch playing a video game about skating instead of going out and, since they have that skill, really skating. You know, why make a video game try to get as realistic as it can with skating when you really know how to skate? For real. To me, the entire game's purpose is a paradox. If it is for real skaters, shouldn't it be less realistic? The real-life skaters, let them do crazy shit that they can't do in real life. Like, oh, I could never do that in real life. And I guess the game kind of does that with Hall & Meat, but in its actual skating section, it doesn't. It's very realistic. So it's not for them. Maybe it's for the non-real-life skaters, people like me who don't really skate in real life. And I don't really care about real life skating. I'm not that interested in real life skating, but I am interested in playing a skating video game. And I don't know how they can't separate the two. Just because I'm running around shooting people and stabbing them doesn't mean I want to go fucking join the Marine Corps. You know, there is a difference there. Black, white, black, white. There's Skate 3 is like a mixture of gray and fuck. So if it's not for them, if it's not for those two people, who's the game for? I think I figured it out. Skate 3's target audience is for gamers who don't skate in real life, but want to learn how. It's a tutorial educational video. It's a demonstration video on how to skate in real life. It must be. I mean, and what's that? What group of, you know, target audience is that? Gamers who don't skate in real life, but want to learn how through the means of a video game. Is it like 30 people in the entire fucking planet that want that to happen? I mean, it isn't a video game as much as it is propaganda for the skating culture. That's what it is. You know, who designed this game? Fucking Goebbels? Fucking skater Goebbels guy? Yeah, make him do a hard flip. Yeah, so anyways, thanks for listening to my rant. If Skate 4 doesn't, you know, address at least half these issues, I ain't fucking buying it. So actually, that's the name of this series. I'm going to start calling it, I ain't fucking buying it. Thanks for listening, and let me practice. Sometimes over here, and see you guys next time.
That was awesome. No, really, that was awesome.